Welcome back, my fans. I was here. Nice. Again, I'm all alone. You know, I took like a 3 to 4 weeks break, and I swear to God, you know, I was ill. You know, I have my excuses. I had UTI. If you don't know what UTI means, it's a urinary tract, whatever thing. You know, it's just like your penis doesn't, you know, it stops. Nothing's coming out, you know, so I had to figure something out and get my... You know, get my junk down there fixed. I promise, as soon as I get back on my feet, I'm gonna start filming. I'm not fully recovered, but, you know, the show have to go, you know? Shows goes on. You know, let's just get down to this goddamn video. Now, me not uploading on YouTube is like Nicki Minaj with no ass. Me not being active on YouTube, it's like the Batman movie was just Riddler in it thinking his followers was straight 3 hours long. Now my knowledge is not that deep, pause, but I'm currently sitting in psychology in my university, and I thought, you know, let's make a video about, you know, something linked to psychology and movies. Now today's video is about psychopath and movies. You know, we've watched a lot of psychopath movies, and let me tell you, they're fucking good. But I'm gonna talk about like 2 movies for this video. Now what does psychopathy mean, and where does it come from? Okay, let me just make this scenario so you can, you know, understand what I'm trying to say. For the ladies only. Boys included. Now you're walking in a park in the middle of the night, and you see this guy. He's charming.
Damn, boy.
Funny and even talented down there. Now for the boys, she's a baddie with big fucking bazoombas, and she's good down there. She's good down there. But the thing that went over your Minecraft square head is that girl, guy you met, they probably killed 10 people before they met you and bathed in their blood. Hey, but you're still smashed though, right? Now, the word psychopathy comes from the German word. Yeah, and most of the credit goes to the German psychiatrist called Julius Ludwig August Kutch. Kutch. Yo, bro. Now, there's a few signs that tell us if someone is psychopath or not. You know, you're not necessarily a psychopath if you have any of them. Unless you like to eat pizza with pineapple. Now the first one is socially responsible behavior. It's like sexual harassment, you know, like some prank channels out there. Kind of psychopathic. Now the second one is disregarding or violating the rights of others. Like,
smells pretty good. Take a nice slice.
Hey, yo, please stop.
Smells pretty good.
Don't you fucking dare. Don't you fucking dare, bro. Don't. Now the third one is the inability to distinguish between right and wrong. Like this, you know. Pretty obvious who's better. Like, come on.
Spider-Man is better.
Now, the next one is the difficulties with showing remorse and empathy. You know, they actually struggle with, understanding people. And the next one is the tendency to lie a lot. So, I lie a lot. So, it's just natural for me. But I'm not psychopathic. Doesn't mean that I'm a psychopath. Now there's a lot of signs that tells if you're a psychopath or not, so you can check that in the description, all of this. Now for everything, there's a pro and cons, so I'm gonna talk about the pros that, you know, it's not like necessarily pros, but like the things that psychopaths have advantage of, you know, more than like a normie like me. I'm just an average Bob. Now one of the pros of being a psychopath, you rarely feel anxious, so that's a good, you know, thing. Yeah, that can help you in like exams. If you're an athlete, that can help you. You're playing Fortnite, you know, there's like 2 left. Some people feel anxious and nervous, and that can actually hinders their, you know, ability to be the best version of themselves. When it comes to manipulation, psychopaths are pretty fucking good with it. They know how to play with people's emotion. That's kind of fucked up because they rarely feel emotion, but they can sense emotions from other people. That's like an advantage. That's cool. But like, don't be a psychopath. No one wants to be a psychopath. You know, a lot of people have fucked up lives, and it's not like they chose to live that life, but you know, that life fucked them up mentally. So after blessing you with my immeasurable knowledge about psychopathy, let's talk about a few fictional characters, and not in an academic way. So without further ado, let's talk about the man, the myth, because I haven't seen him on the screen for like a minute. Christian Bale, playing the role of Patrick Bateman. More like
Patrick Bateman,
a psychotic fictional character. And this movie shows us how Patrick Bateman...
Oh! I'm gonna have fun with this body. Ah, dang.
Oh, bro. My coccyx fucking hurts. Holy shit. Oh. Let me fix it real quick. Woo. Wow. Hallelujah. The fuck just happened? The most obvious scene is where Patrick is doing his morning routine, and that kind of shows us how narcissistic he is and self-obsessed. He only sees the world from his perspective, only.
Don't wear that outfit again.
What? I didn't hear you.
I said, do not wear that outfit again. Wear a dress, a skirt, or something.
You don't like this, I take it.
Come on. You're prettier than that.
Thanks, Patrick.
I'm not here. And high heels. I like high heels.
Now this scene shows us another sign of him violating the rights of others. And more likely, he's telling her to wear something that he likes, not the company, because she's wearing something respectful. He's telling her to wear something to align with his vision. That kind of goes hand in hand with the first sign, and that is being narcissistic and, you know, self-obsessed. Because you want her to align with your vision, you know, not the whole company's vision. But technically, you know, if you look at it from another way, he's the company, if he's like the owner of the company. Oh, I just don't know.
You gotta get your act together. I'll help you.
You are so kind, Mr. You're kind. You're a kind man.
It's okay. I can tell. You know how bad you smell. You reek of shit. Do you know that? Al, I don't have anything in common with you.
Oh, thank you, mister. Thank you. You're right. I'm cold out here.
It's what a fucking loser you are.
What?
I mean, it's crystal clear he can't relate to other people and finds it hard to empathize with other people. I think we call it EDD. Bro, not that, bro! Empathy deficient disorder. Now, a lot of people seen this scene, but the thing people didn't notice about is the emotion Patrick was going through. Some people say he's just envious and this is like a normal emotional condition, but actually this scene shows us an emotional condition called gray rage, aka trigger. By the way, this is not a psychological term. That's what some psychopaths explain it to be, so yeah. This emotional condition happens when someone is asserting their authority on them, but they don't have it. Doesn't matter if it's like physically or metaphorically, like the car shit, you know, that's it. Now if you haven't watched Nightcrawler, please go. Now the creepy thing with this movie, at the end of it, I still wanted Lewis Bloom to get the fucking dub. I don't know why, that was kind of fucked up because he killed someone. But that's what I liked about Nightcrawler, because just having Jake there kind of fucked me up, because I just love Jake Gyllenhaal. And just seeing him on the screen, bro, I just wanted him to take the dub. I'm sorry, I'm a bad person. I mean, even the soundtracks they've used in the background, it was so heroic. And it's like they wanted you to vote for him and vouch for him. And just, yo, I want you to take the dub, kill people, yeah, yeah, whoa, 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 slow down, what the fuck, yo, bro, yeah, nah, bro, Jake. You know, it was serious when I started saying the actor's name, you know, in the movie. Now, despite the fact that Lewis Bloom has a dream of creating this big production company, most psychopaths struggle from creating a long-term goal in their life. And that kind of gets me out of the movie a little bit. But then I remember it's a movie, so I shut the fuck up and get back to it. What I like about Lewis is his story is not realistic, but we all struggle in wanting something or having something. We get so desperate to have that something or get that something. Some of us might break their moral code. You know, we get reached at the end, but we don't, because we have this moral compass and we can tell the discrepancy between right and wrong. But they don't have, and reaching pleasure for them is so hard, so they have to, you know, do whatever to get to that pleasure, no matter what. Now, both characters have something in common, and that is manipulation. They know how to get into people's mind and get what they want. Some strategies are obvious and some are complicated. But most of what I've seen is I give you this, you give me that, supply and demand. On Lewis' side, we can tell his manipulative skills is more displayed than Patrick, as they are more subtle and deceiving. That's what manipulation means. Now, for example, let me show you this scene.
Been asking a lot about your performance review. Given complex problems, you're developing a real ability to find clear, and simple solutions. I'm also aware of your increased enthusiasm. It's great to see your eyes light up when you're working on a new idea.
Thank you, man. I'm trying, you know?
Which is why I'm promoting you.
Does it come with a raise?
Absolutely.
How much?
Pick a number.
You pick a number. It's $75, isn't it?
Agreed.
Wait, what about more?
Not now.
I could have gotten more, couldn't I?
Absolutely.
Now, the reason why he laid it like that, he wanted to give him a raise before he knows about the bag they're about to catch in the next job. So he created this script inside his head on how things are gonna go. He started complimenting him and admiring the work he's done. He wanted him to think this raise was so important for him just to park the car mid-mission and tell him about, you know, the raise. He knew that Rick doesn't know anything about how things go in the business, and he asked for a random number. And when someone is generous, you always have to, you know, lower your standards, because someone is so generous, he took his time to tell you and give you a raise for your hard work, and you feel, oh, this guy is nice, let me just lower the price. There you go, he fell for the trap. Nah, bro, I'm good, bro. Come on, bro.
Hey, just one.
Yeah, I'll get you some.
That's like, what the fuck?
Bro, what the fuck? Wow. Thank you.